Evaluate the definite integral and give the exact value. We have the integral from 0 to 2 of e to the negative 7x dx. Because the integrand function is negative 7x, not just x, we need to use the method of substitution, where we let u equal the exponent of negative 7x. Next, we determine differential u, where differential u is equal to the derivative of negative 7x with respect to x times dx, du equals negative 7 dx. Now we compare u and du to the given integral. We know the exponent of negative 7x is equal to u. Notice this gives us e to the u times dx, and we have du equals negative 7 dx. We'll go ahead and solve this equation for dx by dividing both sides by negative 7, which indicates negative 1/7 du equals dx. Next, we write the integral with respect to u, and because the limits of integration from 0 to 2 are x values, not u values, we will leave the limits of integration off for now. We have the integral of e to the u, and then again dx equals negative 1/7 du. We can write the negative 1/7 either inside or outside the integral. I'll go ahead and include it inside. And now here we have a choice. We can quickly find the antiderivative with respect to u, and then write it in terms of x, and then use the original limits of integration. Or we can find new limits of integration for u and evaluate the integral with respect to u. What I mean by that is, notice when x is equal to 0, because u equals negative 7 times x, u is 0. And when x is 2, u is equal to negative 7 times 2, or negative 14. Now that we have the limits of integration for u, we can go ahead and evaluate this with respect to u and be done. Notice the antiderivative is simply negative 1/7 e to the u. And now we determine big F of negative 14 minus big F of 0. The other option, if we go back to the original integral, is once we find the antiderivative with respect to u, write it back in terms of x, which gives us negative 1/7 e to the negative 7x. If we do this, we use the original limits of integration, which are from 0 to 2. And the result will be the same. For this example, I'll go ahead and show both. Going back to the left, though, we first determine big F of negative 14 minus big F of 0, which gives us negative 1/7 e to the negative 14 minus negative 1/7 e to the 0. Simplifying, the exact value is negative 1/7 e to the negative 14, and because e to the 0 was 1, we have plus 1/7. This is the exact value of the original definite integral. And now going back to the right, with respect to x, we determine big F of 2 minus big F of 0, which will give us the same result. When x is 2, we have negative 1/7 e to the negative 7 times 2, which is negative 14, minus big F of 0, which is negative 1/7 e to the 0, which of course gives us the same result of negative 1/7 e to the negative 14th plus 1/7. Of course, when doing these types of problems, you'll decide whether you want to evaluate the definite integral with respect to u or with respect to x. Just remember, if you evaluate the definite integral with respect to u, you do need to find new limits of integration because you're dealing with u values, not the original x values. I hope you found this helpful.